Whenever I played dress up or home, serving plastic cups in the backyard lawn, I went round and round to wrap the sari around my tiny waist with my tinier fingers. I always wanted to be a mom, to carry a little human in my hands and for the first time believe in love at first sight. To be very cautious about her first steps, but little did I know that I had to be cautious about her every step, even when she was 5, 10, 50. I can't live till 80, but what if someone rapes her and she can't even walk? I want to play peekaboo with her, out close my eyes and open to my entire world giggling. But I don't want to be Asifa's mom, that her mother would shout her name and not hear a giggle back, to find my daughter as a motionless lump. Because the game requires me closing my eyes and not hers. I want to brush my little girl's hair and tell her that she carries dreams in her braids. Just like Nirbhaya's mom, who kept dreaming about tomorrow, unaware of today's blow. I want to tell my daughter that learning is fun. But how will I know that she was not scared of the school? Instead, it was the 60-year auto man I trusted. I want to hug her and kiss her goodnight. But how can I tell her that she is not allowed to go out at night or wear that skirt which I gifted? By the time my sari fitted my waist and I started drinking tea in not so tiny glasses, I knew that I don't want to be a mother anymore. I couldn't tell my daughters stories where the 10-eyed, 4-legged guy wasn't the monster, but the 2-eyed, 2-legged was. I couldn't let my daughter be a meal to the hungry, ill-mannered, not so well-brought up sons. I have lived in this brutal world for all these years. I have more than survived because I have a hero in my life. A hero without a cape, without magical powers, who possesses too much magic. My mother told me that peekaboo should be played with all my senses. She told me that my clothes are my choice. She told me that my gender is the strongest, that it will only rise me up and not put me down. She told me about good touch and bad touch. And when I failed recognizing, she told me it wasn't my fault. But the greatest thing she ever did was, she never told me how to behave. She was busy telling my brother that. When I look at her and look at me, I smile and I say, ditto. And I know how I always wanted to be just like my mother.